Now, for more on this petition filed against Marcos Jr. before the Supreme Court, we're now joined by election lawyer Emil Marañon III. Attorney Marañon, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today. Really appreciate it.
Good afternoon sa inyong lahat. Magandang hapon.
All right, so first off, why is it important for this matter to be brought up to the Supreme Court this early?
Well, actually, hindi na to early eh. In fact, this is already late because alam natin yung takbo ng mga cases in the previous elections. Usually po yung mga ganitong kaso like ineligible or disqualification are actually elevated to the Supreme Court as early as around December. So ngayon po, tapos ng election, yung ngayon lang po inakyat ito sa Korte Suprema. So I will not call it by any way na early, but rather this came too late po.
And this was not by design, because you had to wait, or the petitioners had to wait for the en banc's decision.
Yes, that is correct po. Because under the law, the moment na hindi ka satisfied sa decision ng COMELEC division, antayin muna yung decision ng COMELEC en banc before you can go up to the Supreme Court. And unfortunately, the COMELEC en banc only decided after the elections. So kaya po ngayon lang natin ito nakikita na inaakyat sa Korte Suprema.
So that if people supportive of the administration say that this petition only seeks to sow discord, what do you say to that?
Well, una-una, hindi naman kasalanan ng mga petitioners bakit po na-decide very late in the day na yung COMELEC, in fact, after the elections na, which is actually very unusual or in fact very strange, because as we have witnessed, for example, in the Grace Poe petition back in 2016, as early as December po, natapos na yung kaso sa COMELEC at inakyat na sa Korte Suprema, that in fact, before the elections, the Supreme Court has already decided with finality on the question of her citizenship. But in this case, natapos na po yung election, wala tayong narinig sa COMELEC. And in fact, it was the decision of the COMELEC en banc only came after the elections.
Talk to us about, you know, previous cases, if you know of any. Talk to us about case studies wherein the Supreme Court actually granted a temporary restraining order on the counting of votes, because that's one other factor that the petitioners are seeking before the High Court.
Well, I haven't heard of any case wherein the Supreme Court has issued a TRO or a temporary restraining order to actually stop the counting of votes. Actually po, in fact, my legal opinion on this is that hindi po pwede mag-issue ng suspension as regards the canvassing of votes, because the law governing disqualifications and denied due course, which is RA 6646, specifically in Section 7 thereof, states that the court, in this case, the Supreme Court, because andun ngayon pending ang kaso, may suspend the proclamation but not the canvassing. So we can clearly see that in the provision of the law. So ibig sabihin po niyan, hindi po pwedeng tigilan yung pagbilang or yung pag-canvas ng boto, but the Supreme Court may issue actually a suspension of the proclamation, yung pagproklama po, pag ibig sabihin noon pagkatapos na po ng canvassing.
Because you said that, do you think that the Supreme Court will appreciate this petition piecemeal? Or do you think that this seeking of a TRO on the canvassing will actually be detrimental to the questions, the focus of this petition before the court?
Well, for me, the TRO, whether it will be granted or not, is irrelevant, because at the end of the day, the Supreme Court has the residual jurisdiction to entertain the petition for certiorari filed by the petitioners even after proclamation. So kahit po maproklama na si Bongbong Marcos as the next president of the Republic, it will not stop the Supreme Court from actually entertaining the petition for certiorari filed by the petitioners.
All right, so let's focus on presidential front runner, former Senator Bongbong Marcos now. With this question before the Supreme Court, what does this mean for his impending administration?
Well, basically, there will be like a hanging sword, di ba? Na parang may threat all the time kung hindi ito ma-resolve na Supreme Court as soon as possible. So there will always be the threat that he will be replaced if ever the Supreme Court will decide against him, if ever the Supreme Court will actually decide to reverse the COMELEC and say na disqualified na siya. And of course, if mangyari po ito, either yung cancellation case or yung disqualification case, so may iba-ibang rules na nag-govern dito. So it's either the Vice President who will who will actually succeed, or ang isang alternate option ng Supreme Court is to make actually the second placer in the presidential election seat as the next president of this republic. So merong threat na ganoon. And of course, alam naman natin that this legal issue, of course, question ito ng whether may stability ba yung government or wala, yung considering nga yung top position natin sa gobyerno, may possibility na mapapalitan pa. So alam naman natin na with the change in the presidency, meron din po changes sa policy. So this will be a hanging sword kay Bongbong Marcos if ever he will be proclaimed later on.
We're going to talk more about that in a bit. But first, I have to ask you, what about the 31 million vote mandate? Doesn't that supersede the questions and his certificate of candidacy?
Well, ang paulit-ulit na ruling ng Korte Suprema is that no amount of vote. So kahit sabihin natin na unanimous pa yung boto ng tao, if in case na hindi qualified or disqualified yung isang kandidato, it does not matter. So kahit unanimous pa yan, it will not cure the fact na hindi siya eligible or disqualified siya as a candidate. So it paulit-ulit yung ruling ng Supreme Court. In other words, the Supreme Court has been very consistent that it does not matter.
All right, so you kind of touched on this a while ago. I want to go deeper into it now. So, Attorney Marañon, are you saying that until this issue is resolved, do you think that everything that emanates from this impending administration will be put into question? And I mean everything. We're not just talking about the win here, but policies that will be made by this administration, certain actions that will be made by this administration, the way it governs, will that always be put into question until this issue is resolved?
Yes, definitely, because as I have mentioned, there will always be a threat that he will be replaced as the next president because of this pending question before the Supreme Court. And this is the reason why we have been calling much early on na dapat inakyat na to sa Korte Suprema before pa. And in fact, sinasabi namin noon pa na actually advantages on the part of Bongbong Marcos that these cases are elevated to the Supreme Court as soon as possible rather than this late. Kasi nga, imagine the scenario where siya na yung nanalo sa eleksyon, pagkatapos biglang mag-rule ang Supreme Court na either disqualified siya or hindi siya eligible. Then can you imagine the effect of this in the country? So you think yung 31 million, okay lang ba sila na matanggal siya sa pwesto, notwithstanding that he won, presumably the elections, or imagine the possibility na mapalitan siya later on and there will be changes in the top administration. So this will be a lingering issue na hopefully sana po ma-decide din ng Korte Suprema as soon as possible. Hopefully pag-akyat nila ngayon sa Korte Suprema that the Supreme Court can immediately settle this issue.
And so therefore, to the question of those supportive of this administration, to the petitioners, why can't they just let this be? You have that 31 million mandate. There's a possible sowing of discord here. If the court decides against the former senator, why should this question be asked? And why should this matter be resolved?
Well, una-una, we have to clarify, no? Hindi po kasalanan ng mga petitioners bakit ngayon lang ito inakyat sa Supreme Court. Remember, they have filed as early as October. October last year pa to. And can you imagine for more than 6 months, hindi po ito na-decided ng COMELEC. And ngayon lang po siya inakyat sa Korte Suprema. So in other words, hindi po dapat i-accuse of petitioners or kahit sino man because of the delay. But I think it really falls on the, for example, on the part of the COMELEC, kung bakit inantay pa na matapos ang eleksyon bago na-decidean and sakalang po nung nagkaroon na ng botohan, yung sakalang dinismiss yung kaso. Hopefully po, mas inagahan sana yung pag-decide nito at sana natapos na ito way before the May 9 elections. But unfortunately, andito na nga tayo sa situation na nagkaroon ng delay, severe delay on the part of the COMELEC. And of course, ngayon ang nangyayari is umakyat ito sa Korte Suprema. And of course, by June 30, we anticipate na magkakaroon na po ng proclamation whoever will win in the canvassing before Congress. And of course, as we have repeatedly mentioned, this will be, of course, not only a legal problem, but a question of stability of the country, considering the fact that there is still an opening or a possibility that Bongbong Marcos, notwithstanding him winning the election, na hindi pa rin po siya makaupo because of this disqualification or cancellation case filed before him way back in October.
Attorney Marañon, dun sa mga nag-iisip na bakit hindi na lang pwede pabayaan ito, magkakagulo pa. Bakit hindi na lang hayaan, sundin na lang yung 31 million vote mandate ni former Senator Bongbong Marcos? Ang tanong ko sa inyo, bakit hindi dapat ito hayaan na maging ganito na lang at maging at sumunod na lang dun sa mandato na ibinigay kay former Senator Bongbong Marcos by virtue of the 31 million votes that he garnered during the elections? Go ahead, attorney.
Because at the end of the day, you know, everyone must be reminded that we are still ruled by the law. I mean, hindi pa rin ito palakasan ng boses or palakasan ng sigaw o paramihan ng boto. At the end of the day, the rule of law must prevail. And the law says, pag disqualified ka. Pag hindi ka qualified, hindi ka qualified. So, simple as that. So, ibig sabihin po niyan, that is why the Supreme Court has been very consistent. If you are not qualified, if you are not eligible to run in a particular position, no amount of votes will cure the deficiency. No amount of vote will cure that lack of qualification. So yun po yung paulit.
Attorney Marañon?
Sabi ng Korte Suprema.
Attorney Marañon?
Since time in
final two questions, Attorney Marañon. First off, talk to us about the sense of urgency that is needed now for the Supreme Court to decide on this issue.
Well, of course, for the sake of stability, no, yung parang hindi rin ma-disappoint yung voters si Bongbong Marcos, and at the same time, hindi din po nag-aantay yung buong bayan as regards the issue of whether he is qualified or he has the eligibility to become the president, then there is an urgent need for the Supreme Court to resolve this immediately. So, but ang problema lang po nito is meron pong 30 days yung mga petitioners to actually go up to the Supreme Court. So kung after elections na po yan, mag-aantay pa po tayo ng medyo matagal-tagal pa bago makaakyat yung mga petitioners sa Supreme Court. But hopefully nga po yung best scenario dito is before proclamation sana, but I don't think that can happen considering the fact that medyo complicated ang issue na involved dito, and of course it involves the highest position in the land, so medyo mahaba-haba pong usapan ito sa part ng Supreme Court. But of course the best scenario is they can resolve this as soon as possible.
Alright, now we all know that Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio is looking to have her inauguration, I think, on June 19th. If this isn't resolved then, and if, although you said it a while ago that it's highly not likely that the Supreme Court will actually issue a temporary restraining order on the canvassing of the votes, are we looking at a possible Sara Duterte Carpio sitting in as president if this is resolved, I should say, if this is resolved by then?
Okay. Again, let me refresh no yung nangyari sa COMELEC. So essentially, the issue is as regards Bongbong Marcos not paying his taxes back in 1985. No? So yun yung issue na lingiri ngayon. And there were two types of petitions raised before the COMELEC. One is the denied due course petition, and the second, ito po yung mga disqualification cases. Mm-hmm. Now, pag ang denied due course yung na-decided ng Korte Suprema, then ang effect nito po is as if hindi nag-filed ng Certificate of Candidacy or COC si Bongbong Marcos, this would mean po it is as if he will be treated as if he did not file his certificate of candidacy. It is as if he is not a candidate, and therefore po lahat ng boto cast in his favor will be treated as stray and therefore not be counted or be disregarded by the Supreme Court later on po. So yun po yung effect niya. Mm-hmm. So that this would mean po ang uupo if in case na yung denied due course petition, yung masusustain ng Supreme Court is yung may second number, a second highest number of votes doon sa kinanvas ng Kongreso po. So yung second placer, in other words, which is technically not the second placer but first placer, since yung number one nga po, hindi na siya treated as a candidate. The second scenario is of course the disqualification case. If in case po na yung mangyayari is yung disqualification case yung isustain ng Korte Suprema, what will happen po is that the rule on succession as a general rule will apply. However, there are, ang Supreme Court po medyo flip-flopping as regards the issue kung sino po yung uupo, because there are also cases where the Supreme Court has actually ruled that it is the second placer yung uupo po, hindi yung vice president. So again, pag cancellation case, klaro na yung second placer yung uupo. Pag disqualification case, it's either the vice president, the winning vice president, or the second placer yung pwede pong iproklama ng Korte Suprema.
And finally, can you tell us if you know of any case that the Supreme Court had actually overturned the decision of the COMELEC on bank?
Even the Grace Poe petition, it must be recalled that the Grace Poe petition, dineclare po na ineligible si Grace Poe sa level ng COMELEC, pero pagdating sa Korte Suprema, it was reversed by the Supreme Court. So, of course, hindi naman all the time na kung anong ruling ng COMELEC, yun na po yung i-adopt ng Korte Suprema. So, independent naman ang Supreme Court. So, in any way, we don't expect the Supreme Court to just blindly follow the ruling of the COMELEC, and I'm pretty sure that they will make their own independent assessment of the case and of the evidence presented by the parties.
Election lawyer Emil Marañon III, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Really appreciate it. Take care and you keep safe.
Maraming salamat po.